Let's talk about something that I sort of learned a few years ago. This one is small successes, mini experiments, and momentum. So our brain basically has dopamine receptors. It's dopamine, endorphins. It's like sort of the positive chemicals in our head, the pleasure chemicals. So we have receptors for it, but they did scientific study and they figured out the more you succeed, the more dopamine receptors you develop. The more you fail, the less your dopamine receptors become. The advantage of dopamine receptors is the more you have, the more likely you are to say yes to opportunities, to take more risks, to be more fearless in a way. To take chances when something comes up, build that confidence and whatever. And it doesn't have to be a big success, it could be a small success as well. On the contrary, if you're failing, it doesn't have to be a big failure. Even if, like, it's a small failure, you, I don't know, lost your keys when you were on your way to work, you're our class, you didn't get good grades in your test, in your assignment. You got into a fight with your spouse or whatever, you will start to lose dopamine receptors. The effect it will have is that you will not be as risk averse. You will not be that happy and you will take less risks. Which is sort of good, but it is mostly bad when it starts to build momentum, which is the next thing. Let's say you're succeeding. Ideally, it's better to set small goals because of this reason. So, you instead of wanting to do like 100 push-ups right away, you set your target to one push-up per day. You get it done, you feel good, your body develops dopamine receptors. Next day you do two, next day you do three. And the more dopamine receptors you develop, the more your willpower increases, the more you are likely to take action. And the results you get from it. On the contrary, you keep on failing, you set like a goal to do 100 push-ups right away, or to succeed in a business right away, you know? Like make $1 billion, you fail at it, you won't have any momentum. It will be reverse momentum in a way. You will start refusing opportunities as they come and taking less and less action. I don't understand why, but that's just a principle. And because of that, your life sort of goes into a downward spiral. The reason why we do take focus on small successes is because they're much easier to follow up with bigger ones. Eventually, they will lead you to the same place. Like, instead of right away trying to do 100 push-ups, why don't you start with one and then double that down to two, then to four, then to eight, 16, and it will take almost the same amount of time to get to 100 as it would have otherwise if you were starting out in maybe 40 or 50 and like setting like a really high goal, which you might have failed at. Building momentum also makes the habit more lasting, which is another advantage it brings up. But on the other hand, mini experiments, how it links up with this sort of ability or personality trait is that, let's say you get a business idea. Ideally, you should start anything new that comes to your head, start it within 3 days. If you don't start it, you're most likely never going to do it. Just start it at a smaller level, all right? You shouldn't start it at a bigger level because if you fail, you'll fail big. Start it small, test it out. If it works, good for you. If it does not, move on to the next thing. But the ability to experiment things as they come to you is very special and could really change your life. For example, let's say I'm walking on the beach and I get the idea that I should start a drop shipping company. Okay, that's an interesting idea. Am I gonna start a whole new store right away? Might not be a good idea. Maybe instead of doing that, I can try to create some free marketplace ads of the products I plan on selling to test out their viability. If they get an immediate response, it means the products were good. If they don't, then it was probably a bad idea to begin with. So I sort of saved myself that big loss I was gonna develop. But if it got a good response, the first advantage I have is I started it right away. I didn't have to go through with the headache of setting up a whole store, which might have taken me longer, and might have, I might, like humans have, we don't have that much willpower. It's good to overestimate yourself, but why not play things the safe way? To ensure success, do it at a smaller level. You do the first step, it works, all the products got sold. That makes me feel good. So now I'm going to probably maybe post more ads, start learning more it, building, I can start building a Facebook page, eventually I can build the store. Slowly building yourself up towards it. Like small steps, but a lot of them, instead of like taking one big step in the same amount of time, likely will get you better results. And that is something that's really special. Small changes and small experiments. A lot of ideas, you will get a lot of ideas. There might be someone you need to, like someone you'd like, all right, instead of proposing to them right away. You don't do that, do you? Ask them or talk to them on a little level, not without having any major expectations. You're starting a new diet or a workout plan. Don't immediately cut off everything you were currently eating, like trying to break your current habits and starting a new one. Instead, test out that diet or that specific food just that day, just for the heck of it. See if you like it. If you don't, then don't continue on with it. If you do, then that means it might have been a good idea to pursue it. Then you can start slowly integrating it into your life. But that momentum you will get from it, and the result of the small experiment due to which you immediately started that business, which also kept you safe. Sorry, that overall plan that you had, which also kept you safe from failing big. I think that's a much easier way and much more likely way to get your results, as opposed to going big and trying out your luck and then getting stressed about it. Right?